Hey there, and welcome to the first ever episode of a show that I am calling Splitting Screens. This is going to be a show where I have on friends and guests, and we play a two-player or co-op game. But only split screen, none of that online multiplayer bullshit. So, joining me today, I have my friend and co-host, Doug Shepard, from the show Super Normal.
Hi.
Hi, how's it going, dude?
Not bad, how about you?
Good, you ready to play some PlayStation 2?
I am ready to play some PlayStation 2. It's been a very long time since I've been able to play the PlayStation 2.
Hell yeah. So, as you can see on the screen, we are playing ATV Offroad Fury 3. Now, Doug, you chose this game. Is there any particular reason?
So, I think we've had this conversation in the past, but this game always stuck out to me as a kid, and I just loved it. I've played a lot of different racing and ATV and like motocross games all over the place, but this is the only one that I can think of that really I was able to always just to jump back. I don't know if you remember Dylan,
yeah,
our friend growing up.
Oh yeah,
he actually put me onto these games back with ATV Offroad Fury 1, and we played 1, 2, and 3 together growing up. So it was just always, I knew when I was going over to his house, we were going to have like mac and cheese, pizza, play some games, and usually it led to us just spending all night or day playing this game.
Hell yeah. When do you think is the last time you've played this?
It has probably been over 10 years since I played this game.
I don't think, besides, I downloaded this to sort of see what it was, but I don't think I've ever played this game before today.
See, and I get that from a lot of people. When I ask, or like when we get on the subject of some of our favorite games growing up, I'll say, oh, ATV Offroad Fury, and they're like, really? Like, mine was Halo. I'm like, well, Halo wasn't a bad game. This is just what I always played.
Right. Well, yeah. I think I had, like, a MX versus ATV or something like that. I think that's it. Yeah. All right. So, as you can see here, Doug, we have a few options.
Yes.
On how we can do this split screen. We can do a race, freestyle classic, a championship, waypoint, mini games, or free ride. What do you want to do first?
So I think we should save free ride for later, because that is the main run of this whole game, is that you can just do whatever you want. Not a lot of racing games, especially at this time, were you able to just go around and do whatever you want. This was kind of my first experience with like open world outside of like Super Mario 64 games like that. So it was cool just to be able to drive a vehicle wherever I wanted without having like a certain plot point that you have to get to.
Right.
So let's start with the race.
Let's do a race, man. I'm going to kick your ass.
Oh, you will.
Okay. I don't know what the difference is between all these things, but let's just, do we start amateur or go right to pro?
Go pro or go home, baby.
Go pro, man. Here, what track you want to do? There's so many.
Oh, man.
What is your opinion on cheat codes, real quick?
That's my favorite thing on the planet. I wish they'd bring it back.
Okay, because I put in a cheat code so that way we can get everything already. Don't have to unlock anything.
Oh, you have to.
Yeah. Let's just, let's see, which one sounds the funniest? New Sham Yards.
Spectrodome.
Let's go Glendale Greens.
Glendale Greens. That one sounds familiar.
All right. Do you know the controls at all? Because I do not.
I want to say A to go.
Right.
B to brake. Well, your A and B is much different than mine.
I guess we'll find out here. So yeah. I'm on top, I believe. Oh. Yeah. Shit.
Yep. Oh, here we go. I'm going to kick your dick in.
I don't know.
Ah, how do I go backwards?
Good enough. Maybe X or, you know, yeah. Square.
You know, I gotta say, for this running on, you said this is running off of a capture card.
Yeah.
This is running extremely well.
Yeah, no, it's not that bad. It's a little laggy, but nothing terrible. It's also a PlayStation 2 game that I'm running off of PS3.
Isn't the future amazing? I thought I was going to have to go over to my parents' house and get my old brick PS2 and my physical copy of this game.
I made it through a lap.
I have not.
Dude, I will say straight up, I am terrible at most racing games.
So the only racing game that I ever really actually got decent at was definitely Mario Kart.
I was going to say Mario Kart's like the only somewhat exception.
Yeah, I remember.
But even then, my wife kicks my ass every time we play.
Oh, no. I make it a point to beat the ever-living shit out of my wife in that game.
I'm glad you added in that game there.
I hope you don't edit that out.
Where are you at, Doug? Hell yeah. Shit, dude. I've fallen off the track so many times.
God. See, now it's coming back to me. I sucked at the racing portion, so I would always just do it the free ride.
This game is all about free ride.
Man. No pressure. God, that's like the sixth time in a row that I've just fell off. People are going to watch this and go, wow, it's a good thing he doesn't have Twitch.
Speaking of that, you can follow Doug on Twitch at underscore my name's Doug, your name is not.
Well, now I gotta make a Twitch account.
God, we are so bad at racing. Bringing up the rear. Me and you, man.
We got it.
Oh, yeah. I think we can catch up.
Oh, yeah.
There's time.
This track always reminded me of, like, Excite Bike.
I've never played Excite Bike. Like, I know ever? About it, but yeah.
Like, not even the reboot that they put out on the Wii? Mm-hmm. I know you have it.
That's fair. I probably do have it. I have so many games I've never played, though.
Well, this is a way we can chip away at them. I didn't get a chance to finish the game.
you retired. You did so badly. They were like, that's your last race.
First and last race.
All right, let's quit out of that.
So remember, that was a pro race.
That's true. We are not pros.
We're not pros. Yeah. I've already openly admitted that it's been the better part of 10 years or more since I've played this game.
All right, let's see what else we can do here. Oh, we gotta rejoin. So I'm not sure what Freestyle Classic means.
I do remember Beaver Dam as a place. I think this is kind of like, you remember Skate?
Yeah.
Where you would be able to, like, just get the most points in, like, a certain amount of time.
Oh, right. You want? We can do this.
We can try it, yeah.
Let's give it a shot. I wonder... Ooh, you can change your ATV and stuff. Okay, I'm going to do this real quick.
Oh, you're not going to keep the Patriot?
Wait, is the Patriot, like, the best one? I think.
Oh, I don't know. I was just...
Okay.
It looks
this
cool.
This is all saved from last time, so never mind. I'll keep my stuff, but
and I'm cool with mine too. So
yeah,
yep. Okay, we're good.
Dang! Look at those hills.
Look at all those hills.
Look at all those hills. All right, so I did want to ask you some questions while we're playing here.
Alrighty.
So I'm gonna start off with an easy one here. What games did you like to play a lot when you were younger?
So definitely this for sure. Pretty much anything that Nintendo put out, because, as you know, I've had every mainline Nintendo system that's came out in the United States.
Right.
So with that, I've had a majority of the collection as well. So it's definitely just pretty much anything, mostly platformers. So like a lot of like your Mario, Zelda games for sure. Actually, right. Just recently I started playing through Ocarina of Time.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, those kind of things.
I don't even know how to do tricks on this. Oh, okay, it's B or circle. We're using Xbox controllers.
Well, see, I'm using an
Okay,
Xbox
I'm using
controller.
A Switch controller.
You're using a Switch controller.
You know, I never really liked the PlayStation controllers too much.
I think there was definitely a divide when I was growing up, because there were certain games that I would only be able to play on the PlayStation because that's the only way I ever knew.
Right.
And then I've played the ports of them to other games, like Grand Theft Auto. San Andreas just recently came out on the Xbox One, and that was weird to try to play on an Xbox controller. Because I was so used to my PlayStation 2 controller.
That is understandable. Oh, I'm going out of bounds. Oh, shit. Aw.
Like, look at this. You can go wherever. You can go up this jump or the jump next to it.
That's just, and just full of jumps, baby.
And no one's going to tell you otherwise.
Damn, I'm going out of bounds again. Crash right in.
God, I wish I could remember where most of the stuff was. I remember we'd always start here, and then there was like another section of this that you can go to.
Right, yeah, we're kind of just staying in the same area here. Well, I'm trying to go to a different area, but it keeps sending me out of bounds. All right, so what game do you think growing up had the most effect on your life? Like, I'm not talking like this game made you want to become a doctor or something, but like, what game do you think like directly influenced the games that you play now? You can do a wheelie. Sorry.
It's going to sound incredibly basic, but I would have to say Minecraft.
Oh, really?
Yeah, honestly, with as much fun as I've had with that and as many memories as I have, and how much you can do with it, especially with the way that they're doing stuff now, like it's crazy how much impact that's had on what sort of games I can play. Like, I definitely ask more for like from games that I buy now compared to before, because I want to be able to be creative and I want to be able to kind of do my own thing.
Right.
So I would definitely say that's one of my go-tos.
Oh yeah.
I found this airport hangar thingy.
Oh shit. I wish there was like a map on here where I could find you and run into you.
Yeah,
I'm in like a lumber yard or something. But okay, so Minecraft though. You know, I never really played Minecraft until like when we all played it not that long ago.
So much fun. I saw that today they just released a SpongeBob.
I saw that.
SpongeBob thing. I was super stoked about that.
Also, I kicked your ass, dude.
Oh, yeah, you destroyed me.
Okay, I say either we do some mini games or go right for a free ride. What do you want to do?
Ooh, let's go for a let's see what they have for mini games.
Okay.
Let's see what they have for mini games first.
So there's Tag Ball.
Ah, good old
King
tag.
Of the Hills, Treasure Hunt, Soccer, Basketball, Hockey. Dude,
we're about to play some Rocket League. OG Rocket League.
Let's do it.
There's no way. I do not remember this. So I'll be red team.
Okay. We'll do this, and the next game, we'll be on the same team.
Gotcha.
Okay. So what do you think like got you into video games as a kid?
Well, definitely my parents. My parents were always really big into video games. I remember they had the Atari and the NES growing up.
Also, and this is straight up Rocket League. Sorry.
Oh, my God. It's exactly like Rocket League. But I would definitely say my parents, coupled that with a few good friends of mine that were huge into playing video games.
Right.
Mainly my friend Caleb. I just thought it was phenomenal how many games he had growing up. And I wished that I had that kind of collection. And now I do. How do you go backwards?
I don't know.
I know what I can look at.
Oh, trying to find like a.
Oh, there's none.
There's one before the game, but we didn't pay attention.
We'll find it out.
We'll just deal with it.
Yeah, or we'll just keep going. There we go.
What is it?
I'm just turned all the way around.
Damn it. I gotta say, I do not like the camera angle here.
I know. I definitely like the way Rocket League did it. But I wonder if someone at Rocket League, the people that created that game, played this at one point and said, I want to do this, but better.
Right. your ass, dude. I gotta say, I hate the camera angle so much.
I feel like the controls are a little.
Oh, shit. Oh my god, I went up the dude, I am laying nice. On my side.
2-1, bitch.
I gotta say, though, it's really cool that your parents were so into video games. Like, my parents kind of were, but not nearly as much as your parents.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, god.
Oh, no, I fell off my... I'm stuck.
That's okay. I won't make it. We're just going to run out the clock here.
Sorry, everybody. You got a minute and a half of this.
Oh, maybe. Hey! All I needed was you to be apprehended. Or if I wheelie. Oh, shit.
Oh, should yeah.
Should not have wheelied.
There we go. Oh, yes.
Goalie.
Oh, bitch. Come back here.
I'm a terrible goalie. Dude, this is so difficult. Hey. Oh. Oh my god. I straight up you just can't reverse.
No. I'm almost wondering if there's an issue with the way that it's
oh god damn.
Like the way the controller's reading.
Maybe.
Maybe it's like a formatting thing.
On my way. I'm a goalie. Oh my god. We are very good at this game. Congrats, Doug. You kicked my butt. Oh,
absolutely.
I got negative 1 points on that.
How did that happen? How do you get negative 1 points?
By being me. I can't even imagine how difficult hockey and soccer would be, or basketball. Let's find out.
Yeah, definitely excited about hockey.
Yeah, let's give hockey a shot. I feel like it's gonna be similar.
So can we try to be on the same team? On let's do
we can
it
be red team.
Oh, that sucks.
Damn.
So this was probably a time before bots.
All right. Oh, we're here. Reverse. It's square and X. Okay.
Are you kidding me?
This is why you look at the screen. This is literally just soccer on ice. Well, I guess it's kind of all hockey is anyways. Oh, my God. I knocked you off your butt.
Oh, yeah. Look at that action.
Wait, why am I... Oh my god, I was looking at your thing. I've been watching your screen this whole time. I've been assuming I was blue. It's like, why am I reversing?
Oh.
Did we just level up?
We did.
Oh my god. This is even worse.
Like, I feel like it somewhat has the mechanics of actually being on ice.
It really does. I'm just over here...
I can't get my angles right. So hopefully you all can see why I spent so much time in the free mode.
Fuck. Yeah, I can't even. Where even are you?
I think I got eliminated.
Just gotta take it nice and easy here.
Oh,
No.
I think I straight up got eliminated.
No, you got to be somewhere over there.
I'm nowhere to be seen. Oh, there we go.
Oh.
Oh, shit.
Wait. Oh, shit. That's my goal. No.
Pulled a fast one on you.
Doug. You son of a bitch. You're never coming on the show again.
That's all right. I have a whole nother show.
Oh, my God. I can't believe I just did that. God. I can't even turn or aim. Yeah, get out of here.
I always wondered what actually happened to the company that made this game and why it didn't move up to like newer generations.
Was it THQ that made this? I wasn't paying attention.
I'll actually have to look.
I'll look it up after this game.
Because I know that... What? Oh, player two is goal penalty. Blocking, so you can't block goals? You can't be a goalie?
Apparently not. Come on. No!
Boo.
Put it in, Doug.
No.
Did you see?
All right, well, you bested me on that one.
No, I didn't. I lost. I scored my own goal.
Yeah, yeah. I bested you on that one.
You know, what? Okay, so there's four ATV Offroad Fury games.
Yeah.
Why'd you choose three?
Three was the last one I remember playing.
Okay.
I do remember, like, he had ATV Offroad Fury, which I don't remember if that one had the free mode or not. And then we got ATV Offroad Fury 2. And that one we played a boatload of, because I do remember specifically playing a lot of free mode. And then this one came, and it's like, it was during the era where, like, instead of making a whole brand new game, they would just add more stuff to it. So it was like,
right,
still essentially the same game, but it was, they would just add more things to it.
Right. So this game is developed by Black Rock Studio and Climax Group, two companies I've never heard of.
So they probably just went under,
right,
and probably just never got bought.
Okay, so while we start this next game, you mentioned earlier that you've had almost every Nintendo console.
Yes.
Will you try to give me a rundown right now of all of the consoles you've owned in your life?
So,
like, start to finish, while we load up.
So I know for a fact,
tag ball.
I had the Atari 2600, the Atari 7800. I had the NES. Are you talking just consoles?
Yeah, like, okay. But handhelds too.
Okay, so NES, Super NES, the GameCube, the Wii U, the Nintendo Switch. And then I had my PlayStation 1 and 2, and soon I'm going to have a 3.
Oh yeah, two generations behind.
Then I had a play. Then I did have a PlayStation 4. I sold that.
Right.
My original Xbox, my 360, my 360 Elite, and then I had my Xbox One, the original one that came out, and then I have the X, not the Series X, but the Xbox One X. I've also had the ColecoVision.
Oh, okay.
I had a Neo Geo. I had, I think. I don't remember. I vaguely remember something like that hanging around for a minute. And then, for the handhelds, I definitely remember having the Game Boy.
Like original Game Boy?
The OG Game Boy. I still have my OG Game Boy.
Hell yeah.
And then I got the Game Boy Color. And I don't know what happened to it because I didn't realize that it was so special, but I did have one of the Game Boy lights or like the Game Boy.
Oh,
like,
micro?
Like, yeah, whatever one came out around the same time as the Color in like Japan that had like a backlit.
Oh, okay, yeah.
So I had one of those. I didn't realize that that was like a special deal until I was just recently actually watching a Scott the Waz video he was talking about.
Right.
And I was like, man, I wish I would have known what happened to that. Then my PlayStation or my PSP, my Nintendo DS, my DS Lite, my 3DS. Never had the 3DS, like the new 3DS.
Oh, okay.
But that's right. Coming. I want one of them. That's all I can think of off the top of my head right now.
Is there any certain consoles that you always wanted but never got? Like, haven't got yet, but plan on getting? You mentioned the new 3DS.
So, one that's not necessarily a console, but something that I've always wanted, especially since I got into talks with one of my coworkers, because he builds them. He actually builds arcade cabinets with a Raspberry Pi box in
it. Ooh, okay.
That can play up to 500 games in one. So he said that he'd be able to do that for me for around $400, something like that. I think that that would be fun.
Nice.
Just to have an actual arcade cabinet.
So we were playing tag ball. I just grabbed this thing. I think now you're supposed to try to catch me.
I have an arrow pointing toward wherever you are. So I think that I'm supposed to tag into you and then I have the balls and then you tag into
me. Yeah, it's like whoever has it the longest. Oh, shit. I almost landed right on you.
I see you, motherfucker.
What's in front of me? Oh, God. Was that you?
Nope.
What the fuck was that?
So how come there's a map now? Oh, there we go. I mean, still crashed, but...
Oh, that wasn't you. Was it?
Yeah, I crashed into you.
Oh.
But you have the ball... But no. You don't have the balls
now. Yeah,
it's
right here. Now I have.
Oh, because we crashed.
Okay. So I think instead of you like getting it automatically, here, I'm just going to let you run into me.
No, so I think I have to run into you but not crash. Because if you crash with it, then you drop them.
Ah, okay, no. Shit, I shouldn't let you do that. Aha! Oh, god damn it.
Now I'm gonna win.
That's what you think, motherfucker. Did I just jump over you?
No, I went off the side because I saw what was going to happen.
Son of a bitch. You know, this reminds me of that, that Mario Kart game where you have like the balloons, kind of.
Oh, yeah. Where you gotta pop someone else's balloons.
Yeah. I'm gonna pop your balloons, motherfucker.
You can try. Yay!
Good job, Doug. You kicked my butt. Let's do that one again, now that we know.
That one was fun.
So while we're waiting on this to load, what do you think your all-time favorite game or game series is?
Oh, God.
If you had
to choose.
That's
a hard one. If I had to choose one game series, Kirby.
Kirby?
Yep, gotta go with Kirby. Okay. I don't know. They're easy. They're fun. You can beat them in like 10 minutes.
Yeah, no, I think that's a strong choice.
And I just love the character. Just a dude that can do pretty much anything. Like, super OP. Fun games.
Right.
I feel like I'm kind of all over the place when it comes to like the games. I feel like I haven't been very consistent. But I also feel like I've given myself enough time to like look into a lot of different genres and check a lot of different stuff out.
Right. See, I never played any Kirby games up until like 6 months ago or something like that.
Oh man, Kirby's where it's at.
What do you think, if you had to choose a favorite Kirby game, what would it be?
I would definitely have to say Return to Dream. I want to say it's called Return to Dreamland. Is that the one that's on the Wii?
I think.
I was actually just recently replaying through that one, and it's just fun.
Nice.
I haven't played the new one that's on the Switch yet.
No, yeah, I was going to ask you if you had. It looks pretty good.
I think that's going to be my next buy.
What is it, Forgotten Land?
Forgotten Land or something. I guess it's supposed to be set up more like a Breath of the Wild open world kind of thing. So okay. I think that's interesting because I haven't seen anything like that since, like, technically, the Crystal Shard?
I was going to ask how you felt about Crystal Shard. That's the one I played first.
So that... Motherfucker. I don't know. I might take my answer back because I played a lot of that growing up too.
Yeah, they're fun games, dude. Oh my god, I almost got you. Gotta be honest, knowing you for almost over 20 years, probably.
Yeah.
Didn't think you were gonna say Kirby.
What did you think I was gonna say?
I really don't know. I was honestly really curious, but glad to know the answer. I just ran right into a tree. Motherfucker. These trees keep popping up out of nowhere.
What would you say your favorite game series is?
Probably Pokemon.
That I could see.
Yeah.
I think that's literally the first thing we bonded over at like 4 years old.
Probably.
You like Pokemon? Come to think of it, that's how I made most of my friends when I was like that age.
For Pokemon. Dude, video games bring people together.
Yeah. I don't know if it was more the video game or if it was the card game at that point.
Fair point. Where the fuck did you just go?
I recently looked at the rules for the card game, and it looks like they've changed massively since we were a kid. Like, now they got, like, these coins, and they got to do, like, all this other crazy stuff.
Actually, those have always been there. I think just as kids, we would, like, put them down and be like, ours is a higher level. I win, you know?
That makes sense.
Because... I actually had a video game where it was the trading card game.
Okay.
Like, it was a video game of the trading card game. But so I used to know like how to actually play and like all the rules and all that, but I couldn't tell you now.
Yeah.
But I do remember there even being a coin that you had to flip for something.
I do remember doing like heads or tails.
Right. All right. Let's get some free ride going, man.
Free ride.
All right. Free ride. We're going to go do a pro freestyle. There was one I actually really liked. I think Pro Backyard.
Something's coming back to me.
Yes.
Go back up to event. Is there a way where you can get it to say just free ride?
Believe so.
No. Okay, maybe it is free ride freestyle. Okay. Mm. So I remember this was always a debate with me and Dylan because he would always set it up for freestyle. And it always had a time limit. And I think it would only go up to like 10 minutes. And we were geeks, so we would sit there for hours doing on the same track. So we got tired of having to back out. And then we found out about the free ride thing.
And I believe it's free ride freestyle is the one where you can just do whatever you want. So, like I said, I did download this a little while ago, and I played it a little bit, and I was mostly just doing free rides.
Soccer is best with 4 players. Now we know.
All right. I will say, also, the first jump right here, I've been able to backflip this.
To backflip this?
Yes. It took me so long. Hold on. Let me see. Gotta... Fuck.
Here, I'm backing up. Yeah, I'm backing up.
Some speed. Let's see if I can do it. And I did it first try. It's on video.
Mine didn't happen.
Okay, so it took me a while to figure it out. I was trying to backflip for like an hour. So what you got to do is I forget what it's called, but it's like pre-boost, basically. You just landed right on me. So before you hit the jump, you have to pull back and then pull back again. So basically, okay, you have to pull back twice on your controller. And you have to get a decent amount of speed on them, too.
Oh, gotcha. I felt like I was going a lot faster that time.
Yeah. Yeah, when you just try to pull back, it's just...
So I imagine it's so probably slow. The same way for a front flip, then.
Yes. Yeah, I like that this map is basically just a skate park. Like, and I'm going to land right on my head. There we go.
I remember this is one of the games that I wish you were able to use the multi-tap on. You don't remember the multi-tap?
I have no idea what that
is. Oh my god, okay, so the multi-tap, you plug it into the second controller port and it gives you like 4 or 5 or 6 extra...
Oh, like controller ports?
Controller ports.
Okay.
So my buddies would come over and we'd play a lot of football.
Right.
So that was one way that everyone could play football on one system. And it got pretty chaotic because, you know, everyone's able to control everybody. But it was always really fun. I always thought it'd be cool if you can get everybody doing it. And then, you know, being a kid and now looking back at it, those would be really tiny screens.
That is true.
And then this is probably about the size screen that I had growing up. And I always thought that was fine. And now I got my 60-inch in my room, or in my living room, and I'm like...
I know, even just playing on the computer here, this seems so small.
I know, I should have grabbed my glasses. I'm getting old. Shit.
Okay, let's see if I can... I'm gonna try a front flip here. I don't think I'll get it.
This feels familiar.
Yeah, front flips, you don't really go as fast.
Oh, now I'm out of bounds. Dang. I know there's a couple of these that had like actual like hidden places that you can go.
Oh, really? I just backed up right into a truck. That's okay. It happens.
Backflip. Yeah.
Nice.
That was clean, too.
Oh. I just keep backing up into shit.
I think the only time I ever actually rode a quad was here at your house.
Oh, right.
Like.
Yeah, we used to do this stuff in my backyard.
Yeah, oh my god, we used to make videos. Steven rode on two wheels, I remember.
He did.
The two side wheels.
Sometimes he rode on four.
That's how I usually did it. I used to hook the sled up to the back of it.
You're okay. If you had the choice between owning a quad or a dirt bike, which would you choose?
That's honestly a really tough one. Because I know that I would be using the quad... Mostly when I'm just trying to find like good fishing spots, like if I go up north, like I just want to be able to like get somewhere fast,
right?
Because I'm not into the whole like speed and jumps and crazy stuff like that.
No ka-chow.
That's not for Doug. I like doing it on here. Never in my life would I ever perform a double heart attack like I just did. So probably a quad, just because it's more of a vehicle.
I totally get that. I'd probably choose a quad too.
Yeah. But I would like to eventually try out a dirt bike. It may sway me.
You've never ridden a dirt bike?
Never ridden a dirt bike.
I think I've only ridden one like once.
Where'd you ride a dirt bike?
My cousin's house. Oh, they were big dirt bikers.
Do you remember that kid that lived at the front of like Kingswood, like that house that was on the corner of like Kingswood, and he had like the jumps out back of his house?
Yes,
that kid was cool. I always wanted that. And then we had jumps out behind Ginger Square,
we
too.
Did. There were jumps out there behind the apartments.
I've been meaning to check that out.
See if they're still there. See,
I doubt it, but...
Yeah, kids don't ride bikes these days.
Yeah, kids don't just wander aimlessly through the woods like they used to.
They're on their Fortnorts.
Yeah, they're on their Fortnites getting battle royales.
We say playing video games. Dude, do you think kids nowadays are going to be as nostalgic for like Fortnite as they are as we are for games like this?
I'm going to say so, because yeah. look at the generation before us and how they cream over Pac-Man.
Fair enough.
They're like, oh my god, fucking Pac-Man was my shit growing up. Yeah, it was, because that's all you had. Like when you right. grow, and I mean, like I think people just generally gravitate toward the things that they did when they were a kid, no matter how dull they are. Like I'm sure before that, like people that used to just like throw sticks at each other, like, oh, fucking miss throwing sticks.
Man, we gotta get some sticks going.
Yo, I'll go get some fucking sticks if anyone wants to come over. We're gonna throw them at each other. Back in the day. Actually, RJ and I were just having a very similar conversation about how we miss Pinecone Wars.
It's literally the same thing. And so, same thing you're making fun of here.
I'm not saying that I didn't do it. I'm just saying that like there's people out there, including myself, that feel that way.
Right.
About just like the stupid little things. And like this is just one of those things that I like doing. There was another game that I almost chose that I don't think anyone else is going to choose because it was just such a weird game. It was called Katamari.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And there's one that's actually available right now through Xbox Game Pass, but it's not the one that I played.
Katamari, like Darmacy or something?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah.
And whole point of the game is you are like a little alien guy, and you're supposed to roll everything up into a ball. Everything.
Yep.
So you start with something small, and then you get something that's slightly bigger until all of a sudden you're rolling the whole world up into a planet. And then this big godlike thing just takes the whole thing and throws it up in the sky and turns it into a star or a planet or something.
I gotta say, I never heard of that game before this year, but I did play it on your recommendation.
Yeah.
Loved it.
Right? It's fun. Another one of those little... My buddy Caleb was so good, and he still is, very good at just finding like little stupid hidden gem games. Like, Custom Robo was one that I remember I didn't play a whole... Like, I'd never heard of until I played it with him on his GameCube. And that was another great game that he grew up playing and loved. And I'm like, why didn't we play this more when we were kids? He's like, you always said it was dumb. I'm like, I was a dumb kid. You shouldn't have listened to me.
Right? For anyone listening, yes, I just did just run into the tree, like, four times, at least.
Fourth time's a charm.
It was more than four times. I probably ran into the same tree like eight times.
I am the king of backflips.
Hell yeah.
Now that I got it down, I'm feeling pretty good about it.
All right, you want to try a different map?
Let's do it. Let's see what else is out there.
Okay, so in your life nowadays, do you think you gravitate more towards classic games or newer games?
I definitely now gravitate toward classic games because I really don't have a whole lot of time to play with other people anymore. Or, right. like, our schedules don't add up. So.
Here, I'll let you choose the track.
Alrighty. So, usually, what I'll do is I'll go home and I'll either grab my DS or I'll get on my Wii or even my Xbox or something like that. And I'll just pick out an old game that I know that I can have fun playing on my own. And then I'll just play for a while. My biggest problem, and it's always been my problem, is I will start 10,000 games. And I won't,
get that.
I won't finish one.
I get that.
Although I am pretty far in Ocarina of Time right now. I have the first two stones. Now I have to get the water stone, take that all back to the spiritual thing, get the Ocarina, and kick the shit out of Ganondorf.
I have never beaten a Zelda game.
I think
I've played a lot of them and I've never beaten any of them. I get so upset with them.
I think the only one I beat was like the original one on the NES.
Oh, okay.
And that was through like, it took a lot of time just because I just wasn't putting, like, I'd put the time into it, but it was like over a greater amount of time instead of just like sticking right to it.
Right.
I remember I let Steven use my Switch when he was up at the hospital with his fiance when they were having the baby. Mm-hmm. And I got it back, and I'm opening up all of these games. He beat like 5 or 6 games while he was up there at the hospital. Yeah,
Steven is one of those guys that, like, if they start a game, they're going to beat it.
Yeah.
I am not one of those guys.
Like, do you remember living at the apartment when he beat all of the Batman games?
Yeah, I do remember that.
He beat all the Batman games. I know that he's beaten, like, every Assassin's Creed game that's out there. And I think pretty much anything I've thrown at him, like, hey, man, you should check this out. Like, 2 days later, he's like, yeah, that was a good game.
Right.
I'm like, cool. How far did you get? He's like, oh, I'm done.
Yeah, I'm not that type of guy.
Like, what do you mean done? How do you, like, I don't have that kind of time, but I know he has even less time than I do because he's got 2 kids and he works a job where he's gone a majority of the day. So I think it's just that he's better at it.
That's fair.
Like, he's faster at beating games.
Yeah, I definitely have to have him on here sometime. He'll tell us about all the games he's beaten.
I think it would be phenomenal. I think that's probably going to be your best episode yet.
Well, so far this is the best episode yet.
True. Hopefully it's just like that upward, like every episode gets better and eventually this is the worst episode.
It will be.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Especially with how well we're doing at this game.
All right, so what did you choose here? I have not done this one.
This is City Park. I vaguely remember this place.
Backflip first try? No.
I got scared.
Dude, these games are so much fun, though.
Oh, yeah. I think that's the other thing. Like, a lot of games that I play now, like a lot of the newer ones, they don't have that replayability.
Right. Yeah, especially like story-driven games and stuff.
Yeah, like you get past it and there's not really anything left to do. Like, and for a while, I really didn't play a lot of story-driven games because...
Me either, really.
I would just... I'd either get lost or I'd get stuck or I would finish it when I did finish games. And I'm like, well, what's next? I just gotta wait for the next one to come out.
Oh, God. I went back so high. Flip,
bitch.
This is a cool map.
I remember when the PlayStation 3 came out and Dylan got it. And around that time, MX versus ATV came out.
Right.
And I thought that was like the evolution of this. They just added dirt bikes. And that game turned out to be so different, and I hated every element of it.
Really?
Yeah, I did not like any of those games.
I thought it was pretty much just the continuation of this.
And
what's the difference?
So the biggest difference is there's not really like a decent free play mode, and the controls are way different. The graphics are, of course, better. It's definitely more race-driven.
Right.
So it's more for like the people that like the race aspect and not just being able to fuck around and do whatever you want. And I think that's definitely what drew me toward these games, was being able to do whatever. Because, you know, as a kid, I mean, I only have the attention span of like a goldfish. So I didn't really have to, and on top of that, I mean, just races back to back to back always got boring.
So yeah, I was never too into any type of like racing games like Forza or anything like that.
I think the next closest I got was like Need for Speed, and that's just because of Michael. Like, he was super into the Need for Speed games, but I did like the way that they had it set up where like you could buy different upgrades and do whatever. Get cool new cars.
Right.
But I mean, also kind of one of those, once you've played one, you've played them all.
I will say though, playing the game in like free ride mode like this reminds me more of like Tony Hawk than racing games.
Yeah. Yeah, I was going to say, like, the biggest vibe that I get from this is actually, like, the Dave Mira.
Right.
Like, it reminds me a lot of that. Really wish we could be listening to the soundtrack, though.
Yeah, I was kind of hoping the music would be playing, but we can't really hear it.
Yeah.
So, we're just kind of... I can just mime what I think it's going to be.
I'm just going to guess, like, Paramore and Flyleaf.
All right, I was thinking, like, Headstrong, take you on. I know that was definitely on an ATV game I had. I don't know if it was MX versus ATV, but that was definitely on one of them.
It definitely fits the bill, that's for sure.
I cannot get out of where I am right now.
Well, now we know how to go backwards.
I'm in like a half pipe.
Oh, shit.
I keep jumping and pushing forward, but nothing's happening.
See, I thought that there was a way where you can turn on the map, but I'm not seeing that down there.
Ugh, come on. Oh. I am straight up stuck. I think there's got to be like a... Okay, never mind. I got it.
Yeah, there you go.
I'm just stupid.
I'm trying to do moves, but can't.
I love how different, like, doing tricks on stuff like this is than, like, doing it on a bike. You know, because, like, when you do a bike, you're, like, flipping the bike around and shit.
Yeah, this is just
same
about
like a skateboard. Yeah, this is all about your body.
It's
like I'm gonna fling my body in some weird way.
I'd be afraid of like breaking my neck.
For real. Headstrong, take you on.
Headstrong, I'll take on anyone.
Okay, so if you had to choose between Xbox, PlayStation, and Nintendo, what's your pick?
Oh, Xbox for sure.
Really?
Yeah. Honestly, like as much as I love the first party Nintendo games, I feel like other than Kirby, there's not a whole lot that I've really gravitated back to.
That's fair.
Especially now, and I'm considering now, like if I had to choose one system and someone said you're gonna play this system for the rest of your life, I'd have to go with Xbox just because right now they're buying up so many different companies with a lot of properties that I cared about and like a lot of different games that I liked. And on top of that, they have like the best service when it comes to actually like playing just a boatload of games.
I'd agree with that.
Like the Game Pass, $15 a month, you get the Xbox Gold, plus you get all those different games. And as someone who doesn't play through a whole game and just wants to check out a game and see if I like it,
right,
you know, I'd rather spend $15 a month for 100 games than $60 on one game I'm going to play one time.
Yeah.
What about you?
If what I had to choose between the three?
If you had to choose between
choose Nintendo.
Nintendo?
Yeah, just because there's so many Nintendo games I absolutely love and feel like have such, like, replayability.
Oh, I totally get that. Like, I love my Kirby games. Just recently went back to Super Mario Odyssey.
Oh, such a good game.
I love that game.
Such a good game.
I had incredibly high hopes for that game, and all those hopes came true.
Oh, shit. Dude, I have fallen so many times in this game. Are there any games out there that you absolutely hate and refuse to play? Like anything come to mind where you're like, no, fuck that game?
Not off the top of my head.
No?
No, I can't think of any that I would just refuse to play. I mean, I definitely have a disdain toward like MX versus ATV. I'll still play it.
Right.
But I think a lot of that was because it just kind of didn't fill what I thought it was going to.
Get that.
But there aren't any games that I can think of that I'm like, no, I'd never play that.
Yeah. Same.
None?
No, yeah. Not really.
I know the genre that I try to stay away from that I don't like, probably a lot of those like mobile card games.
Oh, right.
Like Hearthstone and all that stuff. That's fair. Like, I just don't get it.
See, okay, I guess I don't really like games like League of Legends. Is that...
Okay, yeah.
What is that? Is that an MMORPG or something?
Yeah. MMORPG. Yeah. Same with like Dota and stuff like that. Yeah.
I've never really gotten into those. I don't hate them, though. Like, people were like, hey, you want to play this? I'd be like, sure.
I've tried to get into it a couple different times, and I just couldn't.
Damn, I just jumped over a tree and fell.
I mean, one that I recently started going back to were like the first-person shooters.
Okay.
Right. So I've been playing a lot more Call of Duty again lately, because that was another thing that we went on for a while.
See, I played a lot of Call of Duty as a kid, but don't really play it anymore.
I didn't for the longest time, and then just recently I picked it back up again and started playing.
Which one are you playing?
Actually, the newest Black Ops.
Oh, okay.
And then every once in a while I'll play Warzone, because Warzone's always fun. It's just adult Fortnite. Not even adult Fortnite. It's Fortnite with less cartoony stuff.
Well, I'm going to say I could probably sit here and play this game on a free ride for like 10 hours.
Oh, yeah.
This is a very fun game. I could literally just sit here and ride around like one track for hours at least.
See what I mean? Like, that's just how it was growing up. Like, and this is basically what we would do. We would just sit there and we would talk and we would go do something stupid or funny. And then, oh, I didn't get a chance. I wonder if it'll still do it.
Huh.
I can't remember if it was 2 or 3, where if you start, like, if you just try to drive straight off the side of the map, it'll just slingshot your body, and I used to think that it was so funny.
Oh, yeah, with this one, it just puts you out of bounds, I think.
Yeah, it must have been 2.
All right, well, I think that's about going to wrap this up, but before we quit, I would like to ask, if you had to do this again with me, what sort of games would you choose?
Oh, boy, that's a tough one. There's a couple different ones that come to mind. A couple of them that I brought up, like definitely, custom Robo would be one that I want to try. Also Katamari, I think that'd be.
Is Katamari two player?
The one that was on PlayStation 2 was.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure. Again, it's probably been over a decade or so since I've played it, but probably those kind of games.
Hell yeah. Alright, well, I just got stuck on a thing and it flung me off. So I think that's a good time to end this.
I'd say so.
Well, Doug, thanks for joining me and playing some ATV Offroad Fury 3 with me. I hope you had fun.
Absolutely, I did. This was a blast.
Hell yeah. Yeah, this is the like pilot episode of this, so who knows if this will even be a thing. I had fun.
Yeah. I could definitely see this going, because I feel like everyone that comes to the show is going to have something different to bring.
Right.
And you're going to, and I feel like even with as long as we've known each other, I think we've learned some things about each other that we didn't know.
No, I know everything about you.
Well, I definitely learned some.
Oh, good for you.
I guess I just wasn't paying attention.
Yeah, you should have paid more attention to me.
Yeah. You were probably like screaming it from like the rooftop too. Like,
yeah, every day.
Growing up. And I was just like, nope. I'm going to listen to it, you know, not for another 15 years.
All right. Well, thank you for joining me. Thank you, Doug, for joining me.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, anytime. And we'll see if this continues to be a thing. Dude, your character was just like, hey, what are you doing?
Because we're just just wondering.
Let's see here for a second. Yeah, see if they do it again.
I think he just kind of turns. Yeah, he just turns around. He's like. Yeah, and checks his watch. My guy. Check his watch, yeah.
They're kind of dicks.
Yeah. It hasn't even been that long.